Welcome back to the Astral Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And I'm going to show you how to very easily do the new C-Star update, which includes the flat framed options or the flat shoots. Super important to do this. I totally recommend for you to do it. And I'm going to show you a very quick, easy way to do it. It should take you less than 5 minutes. Now, the C-Star has a very good tutorial on how to do this, but before I get into the very minimal steps that you need to be able to do this successfully, I just wanted to talk about real briefly the importance as to why you should do this and what this actually even means. What is the whole point of this? So the point of flat frames is to get an overall better image quality, enhanced image of the object, a deep space object that you are taking. So you're going to have three reasons why you want to do this. Number one is to correct vignetting. Now, vignetting will help even out the brightness across your image. It will remove dark spots that can appear in the corner of your images. Number two, it will also remove dust spots or other debris that's, for instance, on your sensor or in the optical path of whatever image that you are taking, which can sometimes appear in the final image as dark spots as well. And number three, it will enhance the overall image quality. So it's going to correct imperfections and it will contribute to a cleaner, a more accurate image representation of the deep space object that you are taking. So you definitely want to do this. Now, let me show you how to just get to it. Hey, if you're finding this content valuable, make sure you hit the like and make sure you subscribe. My YouTube analytics says that over 50% that come back to this channel over and over again are not subscribed. So if you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe. And feel free to send me a thank you by donating. You can donate any amount or buy me a coffee. The link is in the description and it's just a way for you to show your support. Thank you so much. Once you have your C-Star on, and remember, this will apply to either your C-Star S30 or your C-Star S50, okay? So you're going to do the exact same steps. So you're going to open up your C-Star app, turn on your C-Stars. Once you get to the home page, you're going to want to open up your sensor, okay? Just go ahead and open up, do the open arm function, okay? Okay, so once your C-Star arm is open halfway, you're going to go to your advanced features. In your advanced features, you're going to see an option that says image calibration and flat shoot. Go ahead and click on shoot and it'll have you go through the tutorial. So just let it go through the tutorial, let it do its thing. And with that joystick, what you're going to need to do is open up your C-Star lens all the way up. The C-Star app will actually tell you in the tutorial, you can use a white sheet of paper or you can use a device like a tablet. For instance, so that's exactly what I did. Remember, you don't have to be outside to do this. You can do this in the comfort of your own home. Of course, you can do it outside, but there is absolutely no need, as you see here. It'll still be successful in this manner. Okay, so once you see that your C-Star lens is completely straight up, all I did was go to a website that's called blankwhitescreen.com. You can literally open up your favorite browser, whether that be Safari or your Google Chrome, Google or search blank white screen. The first option that comes up will be a secure website that just says blankwhitescreen.com. Then you're going to grab your device, the white screen, and you're going to put it right on your device. Make sure it doesn't fall. Okay. What I did is I used it, the big one on the iPad, and then I used my phone on the S30, just because of the way, just because it was easier, I knew these weren't going to fall. Okay, that's basically what I did. So once you have your device with the white screen on there, all you need to do now is click on shoot, right? Take your flats. Only takes a few seconds. You're going to hear three clicks because remember, this has different filters in there, right? The IR cut filter, the light pollution filter. You're going to hear three clicks, okay? Once that's done, it'll actually tell you if it did it successfully. It'll tell you flat shoot succeeded. That's it. That's all you need to do. And like I said, you can do the same process both for your S30 or your S50. And that's it.